Greetings. I started this video emotionally on the edge of tears. By the end, I felt the peace of the Lord. I pray that you would be blessed and encouraged as you watch. The truth has no skin color. Get used to hearing that. Think about it and meditate on it. We all need to hear it loud and often. I used to attend a large church. In that church, an amazing situation happened. I met me. I did not say I found myself. I did not achieve some self-actualization. I met me. I met a brother who had my name. He was 6 inches taller than me and outweighed me by 80 pounds. He loved the Lord just like I did. He always had a huge smile, and he had the most amazing permatan. And I recall every time I'd see him, I'd make time to give him a huge hug. Thinking about him brings a smile to my face. It also brings tears to my eyes. Some tears are of joy, of the love and fellowship I had with this brother. For he is my brother from the same Father God. Brothers from another mother, some would say. Some tears are of sadness, a deep, heart-hurting sense of weeping that any who claim to be Christian have hate in their hearts. The truth has no skin color. To be Christian is more than a social behavior. The gospel is a message of love more than simply behavior. The behavior arises because of the love, and it began with God. John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave the only begotten Son, so that everyone believing in him should not perish, but should have eternal life." Romans 5:8, "But God proves his love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." Please, please, please allow that to sink in. God has already proven his love, but God proves his love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. While we were still sinners. This is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. John 13:34, "A new commandment I give to you, that you should love one another. As I have loved you, so you also should love one another." Let me ask you a question. Who was Jesus speaking to here? Was Jesus saying this to Christians, to the First Episcopal Church of Atlanta, to the Third Baptist Church of Valdosta, Georgia, to the choir at St. George's Cathedral? Was Jesus saying, "Christians, love other Christians"? No, Jesus was saying, "Love all men," and that includes women and children too. Jesus was not saying, "Love those with the same skin color." The truth has no skin color. God's love has been freely given to us. Why? So that you may love with abandon. "Yeah, but if I love Muslims, they may cut off my head." Good for you, you lucky dog. 2 Corinthians 5:8. "We are of good courage, I say, and prefer rather to be absent from the body and to be at home with the Lord." If Muslims separate your head from your body, you are then present with the Lord. If they kill you, you've won. Then you too may proclaim as Paul did. 1 Corinthians 15:55, "Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting?" Let that sink in. Where, O death, is your victory? Where is your sting? Death has no sting. Even in death, you have life. John 11:25, Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even if he dies." This is where your belief meets the road. Revelation 12:11, "And they have defeated him by the blood of the Lamb and by their testimony, and they did not love their lives so much that they were afraid to die." When the Muslims put the knife to your neck, out of the abundance of your heart, your mouth will speak. Matthew 12:34, Part B, "For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks." Until that time, speak the truth in love. Ephesians 4:15, "Instead, speaking the truth in love, we will in all things grow up into Christ himself, who is the head." How do you do that? How do you get to that place? Let's go back a few verses. Ephesians 4:11, "And it was he who gave some to be apostles, some to be prophets, some to be evangelists, and some to be pastors and teachers, to equip the saints for works of ministry, to build up the body of Christ." Those five kinds of people exist to equip you so that you may go about Jesus' work. That includes equipping you to perhaps be one of those five kinds of people. You may already be one of those five kinds of people in the ministry. Until we all reach unity in the faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God, as we mature to the full measure of the stature of Christ. This is a maturing or growth process for all of us. But do not misread this verse and imply something not said. This verse does not say, Jesus will not come back until we are all united in one faith. But I believe you will hear this taught, perhaps using this verse, to support a one-world religion. The thing we need to do is realize the truth has no skin color. The truth teaches us to love. Love your fellow man, not your life. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.